Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about one modulation system, that is EDM and delta sigma modulator system from the digital communication. So the contents are the EDM transmitter, that is adaptive delta modulator transmitter, EDM receiver, advantages of EDM, delta sigma modulator and demodulator. So we have, in the last lecture we have studied the system, that is delta modulator system. We have seen the advantages, disadvantages, then what is the transmission bandwidth, bit rate, all that things we have seen for the delta modulator system. So one disadvantage of delta modulator system is it has two distortions, that is slow polar distortion and granular noise buffer, and that are basically due to the step size is fixed. So to overcome that disadvantages which are present in delta modulator system, the adaptive delta modulation system is used, which is also known as a ADM system. So in ADM system, the step size is not constant. Rather, when the slow polar distortion occurs, the step size becomes progressive larger, and therefore x dash of t will catch up with x of t more rapidly. Whenever the slope of the input signal is large, the step size of the staircase approximated signal x dash of t is increased. On the other hand, when the input signal is varying slowly, the step size is reduced. Thus, the step size is adapted as per the level of the input signal over here. So, in EDM transmitter, we can see that here, this is the same block diagram for the delta modulator with the one addition, that is one more block is added, that is logic for step size control over here. So, from the DM output, it is given to the logic for step size control, and that is given to your 1-bit quantizer. Otherwise, this is the delta modulator system with the one addition of the block, that is logic for step size control. If we compare the block diagrams, one change we are getting, that is logic for step size control is added over here. So, into this, basically, here, the step size is controlled by using the one more block, that is logic for step size control over here. So automatically, whenever it is required to increase the step size, it is done with this block. Whenever the input signal x of t is constant, on that time step size will be reduced over here. So we can find out here one more block diagram for the ADM system, that is adaptive delta system, delta modulator. So, in this, if you again compare with the previous one, input signal x of t is compared with x dash of t. With the help of comparator, the error signal will be generated, or either your output will be high or low depending on the comparison that is applied to sample and hold circuit. Now, instead of up-down counter, here we are using a digital processor which will be taking actions depending on the clock pulses over here. So digital pulse processor is used instead of up and down converter, and then the output of this digital processor, it is applied to D to A converter, so which will be generating a approximated analog signal. Again, the comparison between x of t and x dash of t will be done, and the output is given to the sample and hold circuit over here. So in response to the clock pulses trailing edges, the processor generates a step which is equal in magnitude to the step generated in response to the previous clock edges. So if the direction of both these steps is same, then the processor will increase the magnitude of the present step size by delta. If the directions are opposite, then the processor will decrease the magnitude of the present step size by delta. So here the output signal SO of t, that is the output of ADM system, mathematically we can express this here, that is plus 1 if x of t is greater than x dash of t just before the clock pulse over here. Now we can see this is the ADM waveform. In previous delta modulator system we have seen if the slope of x of t is high, in case of that here we can see that is delta modulated approximated signal. Here, this is delta modulated approximated signal, and this is your x of t. So, this slow polar distortion was occurring in delta modulator. But now in ADM, what is happening? That step size is now variable. So, due to that, we can If the slope of x of t is large, then we can increase the step size of ADM or approximated signal. Here in this case we can see normally it is delta. In this case, as the slope of x of t is large, it is increased, that is 2 delta. Again, for one cycle it is hold constant. Again the comparison will be done. It is very large, so it is 3 delta, then 4 delta. Now at this instant we can find out that is x of t is smaller than this. So it is decreased to 3 delta, that is minus 3 delta. Then again here at this step we can find out that it is high. So 1 delta, half of this, and again it is decreased. So in this way we can control SOD as well as granular noise over here. So here we can find out mathematically we can express this, that is SO of t is positive if x of t is greater than x dash of t, or it is negative if x of t is less than x dash of t just before the kth clock edge. So then the step size at the sampling instant k we can find out. Means how to find out the increasing in the step size, that is 2 delta, 3 delta, 4 delta. How to find out this increase in the step size? So for that we can use the formula del of k is equal to del of k minus 1 into SO of k, that is output at the kth clock pulse, plus delta into SO of k minus 1. So we can find out here del of k is basically a step size at kth clock edge. Del of k minus 1 is step size at k minus 1th clock edge. SO of k is basically output at the kth edge. Del is a basic step size. And SO of k minus 1, that is output at k minus 1th clock edge. So we can take one example over here. Assume that is k is equal to 6 in this case. So for k is equal to 6, we can find out at this point over here. Here we are. So k minus 1 is 5, so we can find out del of k minus 1, that is del of 5. Del of 5 is basically what? Del of 5 is basically increase in the step size, that is delta. So we can find out, we can write del of 5, that is at the 5th clock edge, that is delta. If it was like decreasing on that, in that case you can write like minus delta. Now SO of k, that is output at kth clock edge, means output at 5th clock is equal to SO of 6th is equal to plus 1 over here. So output of k minus 1 you can find out, that is before this SO of 6, before 1 clock edge, SO of k minus 1, SO of 5 is equal to plus 1 over here. So we can find out, if you put this all this into this equation, we can find out del of k is equal to 6, that means del of 6 is equal to this, we are having delta, SO of k we are having plus 1, so it is plus delta or only delta. Now delta, this delta, and SO of k minus 1 is also plus 1. So this is delta plus delta, we will be having 2 delta. So the step size at the 6th clock is 2 delta. So here we can find out, that is after this, means by using the step size at the previous stage, that is at the 5th clock edge, we can find out the step size at 6th clock edge, that is it is coming 2 delta over here. So similarly, by putting all the values by using the previous stage outputs, we can find out for output at the 7th clock edge, 8th clock edge similarly. So these are the adaptive delta modulation. Adaptive means variable step size, variable delta. That is variable step size. So the disadvantages and advantages we can find out. Advantages of ADM system over delta modulator system. Now the distortions which were present in the delta modulator system, that is SOD and granular noise, low polar distortion and granular noise, these are reduced. Improvement in signal to noise ratio. Then wide dynamic range due to variable step size. Better utilization of bandwidth as compared to delta modulator. Then if you find out, low signaling rate, and the last, that is simplicity in the implementation. Now again this is for the ADM receiver. So simply we can find out this for the ADM receiver. So if you find out here, if you see the right hand side of this block diagram, we can easily find out it's a linear delta modulator receiver itself. So the simple one thing we need to do, that is that ADM signal is first converted into DM signal with the help of logic for the step size control over here, and then it is applied to the DM receiver itself. So we know already how the working of DM receiver, that is the delta modulator receiver. So only one additional thing we need to do, we need to convert this signal into delta modulator and then apply it to DM receiver over here. So at the output of low pass filter, we'll get the original signal back. So this is all about ADM system. Now, the next thing, that is, as we are having ADM system, DM system, PCM system, then one more system or one more modulator is there, that is known as a delta modulator system. So we need to first find out what is the need of delta modulator system over here. So the quantizer input in the conventional delta modulator can be considered as an approximation to the derivative of the input message signal. So the noise results in an accumulated error in the demodulated signal. So this is the drawback of the conventional delta modulator. This can be overcome by using a delta sigma modulator. So this is one more modulator, that is delta sigma. In the delta sigma modulator, the input sign is passed through an integrator before applying it to the DM circuit. So this is the block diagram for the delta sigma modulator. So here what we are having in the initially, as I told you, that is it is passed through a integrator, then it is applied to a comparator over here. One more circuit we are having, that is hard limiter is there, then product modulator we are having, and then it is applied to a low pass filter. In the feedback also one more integrator is used over here. So here the low frequency components in the input signal are boosted or pre-emphasized by using the integrator over here. And the correlation between the adjacent samples of the delta modulator system is increased. This improves the overall system performance due to reduction in the variance of the error signal at the quantizer input. So it simplifies the receiver design. So in the block diagram we can find out the M of T signal, that is a message signal which is a continuous time signal, and it is first passed through an integrator and the comparator. The comparator compares the output and it is applied to the pulse modulator block. It consists of hard limiter and a product modulator also. So the input output characteristic of the hard limiter circuit, we know that is, if the input to this block is negative, it will produce minus 1, and if the output minus 1 output, and for all positive input, it produces plus 1 output. So the hard limiter output, that is plus minus 1, is applied to a multiplier, that is product modulator, and the other input to the multiplier is clock pulses produced by the external pulse generator. So the frequency of the clock pulses should be higher than Nyquist rate over here, that is your FS. At the output of the product modulator, we get the sampled version of the limiter output. It is transmitted over the communication channel. Thus, we transmit a 1-bit encoded signal with the help of this. And the same output signal is applied to the second integrator. And this second integrator is compared. It is compared with the output of integrator 1 with the help of comparator again. So this is the delta sigma modulator. One more diagram we are having, that is simplified delta sigma modulator system. Since integration is linear operation, we can combine the integrator 1 and integrator 2 in one integrator, which is placed after the comparator. This will simplify the transmitter design to some extent. So the advantages of delta sigma system over the conventional delta modulator, we can find out here by using or by just checking the in use of integrator over here. So integrator 1 and 2 is combined, and this is a modified delta sigma modulator over here. Thank you.